Guys, here we have it, the Sentry's UC9, or I guess the you could call it the Uzi, the civilian Uzi semi-auto. Pretty nice looking gun, guys. It's pretty cool looking. I mean, I think this is going to be purchased, like all of us, for the cool factor. It's got the long barrel to keep it legal, and this is in the folded position. This has the stock here, which you can pull out. You push down here and you pull up, get it locked in place, and then you can get a nice firing position from the shoulder there. Magazine, drop out right here, 32 round magazine. Loading this is not exactly fun. You can get about 25 in here, and then prepare for your thumb to start hurting for the rest of them there, the next 7. But this has the standard Uzi mags. The furniture, from what I'm told, is in a lot of these parts, including the barrel, are from actual Uzis. And then Sentry makes this into the semi-auto. The receiver is different on the inside as far as the internals, making it fully automatic. This is a closed bolt firing versus the full auto Uzi is the open bolt. Breaking this down is pretty darn easy. Just going to pull this little tab back here. And you can lift up, this comes out, and you can see there's the charging section there with the little with the spring. I don't know how easily you can see that. There we go. And safety fire up, by the way, is right here. Taking this apart is pretty darn easy. Just pull back here, and you can pull that out. There's the firing pin. And you can see there where the two springs, I don't know if you can see that, but where the holes where the two springs go. And then if you want to take the barrel out, you're just going to push down right here and twist this barrel nut off. Take that off. And you can pull this barrel right out. Boom. Talk about easy, huh? And that's pretty darn easy to clean. I shot maybe 4 magazines through this, and well, not too bad, a little dirty. Putting this back together, it's easy. I mean, you can't really mess this up. Barrel goes back in there, and you turn it, it seats. There's a little things that, oh, I'm out of the camera view. There we go. You can see it just fits right in there. And put the barrel nut back on there. It's hard to do this by myself. There we go. Twist that on, and then you'll hear that. Push this down, keep twisting till you can't twist anymore. Let go, and then it's locked on there. Putting this back together, I put the firing pin. Oh, did I do that through? Hold on a second here. Let me figure this out. There we go. You can see the hole for the firing pin right there. So you put the pin through there, and it'll fit on like that. You've got the large spring on the bottom, small one on top. And you can see right where that fits in, there. I don't know if you can see, that's hard. Anyway, you'll see it when you're doing this. Put those springs in the corresponding holes. Pull this down. It's in there. Now put the cover back on the front first, and you can just pop this down. Boom. It's ready to rock and roll. Again, I shot this. It's pretty accurate. Surprising enough. I mean, you can see the little hole there for firing. It says 100 and 200. It's surprising enough. This is pretty darn accurate. I had some, first time shooting it, I had some cans, maybe about 25, 40 yards away. I was popping these off, no problem, didn't even adjust the sights. So again, I mean, this is just for fun. It's a cool looking gun, and enjoy shooting it.